Assalamu alaikum everyone. In this lesson, I will describe the path goal theory of leadership. We have already discussed in the last lecture Fiedler's contingency model. Another contingency theory of leadership is path goal theory of leadership. The objective of this lesson is to explain the path goal theory of leadership effectiveness. Path goal theory of leadership is another contingency model developed in early 1970s by H. Robert. The theory specifies the effective leadership behavior needed to achieve high productivity and raise morale of employees in a given situation. In general, path goal theory proposes that the leader's role is to clear the paths that team use to achieve objectives. The conceptual basis for the path goal theory is the expectancy model of motivation. This model describes how individuals make rational choices about their behavior based on their perceptions of the degree to which their effort and performance can lead to desired outcomes. It is the leader's responsibility to increase team motivation to accomplishment of goals. The leader increases team motivation by two ways. The one is clearing the path to goal, and the second is increasing the rewards that followers desire. Clearing path means leader clearly gives the task description, work procedures, role descriptions, and performance standards. It would give followers increased knowledge of the task and confidence in accomplishing the goal. Whereas increasing reward means that leader learns which rewards are important to a follower, whether they wish for intrinsic rewards from the work itself or extrinsic rewards such as pay raises or promotions. As you can see in this diagram, that according to the path goal theory, leadership style is contingent upon two things: team member characteristics and the nature of task in order to give desired outcomes. The outcome can be measured using productivity and the morale of the employees. Hence, the major proposition of the path goal theory is that manager should choose a leadership style that considers the group member characteristics and the nature of the task to achieve the desired outcome, as well as to boost the morale of the employees. The path goal theory identifies two important sets of contingencies: personal characteristics of the followers. These include factors such as employees' abilities, their experience, their needs, and the motivation level. For example, if an employee has a low level of ability or skill, the leader may need to provide additional training or coaching to that worker so he could improve performance. Another example is professionals or the experienced workers. They want more freedom and autonomy and they work best under a participative leadership style. The second contingency is the nature of the task. This includes the extent to which tasks are defined, the processes are well proven, the employees' roles are defined, and the quality standards have been set to measure the performance. For example, if the task is new and unclear, the followers are likely to waste their efforts due to a lack of knowledge and experience. They might feel frustrated and unmotivated. So the leader must provide instructions and training, thereby removing obstacles to followers' performance. However, if the task is routine and team members performed it successfully a number of times, then they might feel boredom in that task. So in this situation, leader uses motivational behavior. He gives employees necessary guidance, listens to their problems, and these tasks, they demand a relationship-oriented behavior. Pathkohl model suggests that effective leaders should exhibit behaviors that add to team's abilities and task nature. These behaviors must look for the needs and satisfaction of group members and compensate for any deficiencies. The model recognizes four behavior types, such as directive behavior, supportive leadership behavior, participative leadership, and achievement-oriented leadership. Directive leadership tells subordinates exactly what they are supposed to do. Leader behavior includes planning, making schedules, setting performance standards, and stressing adherence to rules and regulations. The supportive leadership shows concern for employees' well-being and personal needs. Leadership behavior is friendly, caring, and approachable. This style is suitable when job is stressful and frustrating. Participative leadership style is suitable with skilled group members. Leader consults with subordinates about decisions regarding important matters. Leader behavior includes asking for opinions and suggestions, encouraging participation in decision making. Achievement-oriented leader set goals that are challenging and require continuous improvement. These leaders also show confidence in team and assist them in learning how to improve further. This style adds to the abilities of already competent and committed class of employees and suitable to carry out entrepreneurial jobs. As the model suggests that the leader's responsibility is to clarify the path to goals and to increase the amount of rewards. Leader should take following necessary steps to influence the employee's performance and job satisfaction level. Leader must recognize the team member needs, that what they want. Either they need directive leadership behavior, they need caring attitude from leaders, are what they value most. Leader must know the desires and the demands of his team members. Secondly, leader can increase the employee's job satisfaction by increasing the personal payoffs. The leader might give high performing employees special recognition. He can give them pay raises to increase their motivation. And thirdly, leader must provide coaching and direction. He should make the paths to goals easier by providing coaching and necessary direction. Leader must arrange trainings for those workers who needed to raise their confidence level. And leaders should supply task structure if it is missing. He should clearly define the roles of the employees. He should clearly define the objective of the task and the processes that can be adopted to accomplish the task. And finally, leader should not irritate people by giving instructions on those things which team members already know. In path goal theory, employee satisfaction and motivation have been used as key factors for leadership effectiveness. This view broadens our understanding of leadership and consideration of followers for achieving goals. Model pinpoints that a leader's action has a major impact on satisfaction and motivation of individuals. The extent to which team members look for challenges and desire to be autonomous is a determinant of leaders' behavior. Moreover, the theory emphasizes that leader needs to clear the path to goal achievement. It further substantiates the obstacle remover role that has already been described for team leaders and managers. Despite its potential benefits, the model is generally under-researched and not widely accepted. The leaders and managers have not paid much attention to the path goal theory. Thank you.